controlling of apana vayu. In the body systems, according to the texts of yoga, prana and apana are two important air systems which are related with the classical yoga practices. The classical yoga texts mention 5 important varieties of pranas, namely prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. They also mention 5 secondary pranas called as naga, kurma, krukara, devadatta and dhananjaya. Of these, prana and apana are considered to be very very important, and the entire system of pranayama has been moving around the integration of the prana in apana and the apana in prana. And prana always moves upwards. Prana is translated to be vital force, whereas apana is always moving downwards. It is translated as the excretory force. Actually, the apana is having a major role in the purification of the body, in the promotion of the fertility aspect, and also in controlling some of the systems interrelated with the excretion and other aspects. According to classical yoga texts, the genitals and the anus are two important places for the function of apana. Physiologically, apana controls the functions of the kidneys, urination, ejaculation, excretion of the feces, and also menstruation. These 5 are interrelated with the gastrointestinal system, nephrological system, purification of blood, urination, and reproductive system. The entire subnaval region is totally under the control of apana vayu. Thus, management organization of apana vayu is very important factor in yoga therapy. It can remove the problems like constipation, diarrhea, problems of ejaculation and menstruation. And the control of apana vayu also will be stabilizing the important aspects of the limbs like kidneys, nephrons, and also the aspects like uterus, endometrium and the like. They are all protected. In one way, the apana vayu will be totally purifying the body, and it is activating the biomagnetic energy. Here, the purification of the body and the activation of the biomagnetic energy are two direct functions which will be promoting immunity within the body. And for that, different yoga methods can be practiced in case of the risk factors. Nowadays, most of the women are suffering from the problems of menstruation. In the same way, the problems of obesity and the problems related with the delivery of the child, etc., they are all interconnected. And the problems of menstruation are also associated with the improper management of the apana system. And that is why this entire apana or the excretory force must be totally maintained and handled through different yoga methods. And for that, some methods are herewith suggested. The most important method can be found in what is called as Ashwani Mudra. Ashwani Mudra is basically involving with the contraction of the sphincter muscles of the anus region. As a result, it will be promoting a level of immunity and strengthens the intra-colon function. As a result, the colon will be more powerful and the problems of some of the anus will be rectified, and the problems like colonitis can be avoided through the Ashwani Mudra. And references from Yoga Shikhoparishad are very clearly indicating that one who practices this particular Ashwani Mudra will always can come out of the flanks of the death. And there is one more method, what is called as Moolabandha. Moolabandha is always keeping the transnaval region and the subnaval region contracted. This is interrelated with the pranayama system and moolabandha will be making the contractility of the tissues there, and it will be compressing and creating an environment of self-suppressive surrounding pressure force, which will be strengthening the tissues where more energy is used in the discharge of so many things. And there are some important asanas for this particular purpose. Of that, Siddhasana is considered to be very, very important. According to Hatha Yoga Pradipika, Siddhasana is said to be more important out of the 84 asanas. And one who practices Siddhasana will be having good results. And when we practice Siddhasana, there is Siddha Yoni Asana also, which is basically suggested for the female people. And Siddhasana will be giving good results when it is properly practiced with Chin Mudra and Yamapasha Mudra also. And there is one more asana which we can suggest generally for practicing the compression of the subnaval region, what is called as Ardha Padmasana. Ardha Padmasana keeps the body, which is below the navel, somewhat free. At the same time, it will be integrating the energy within. And Padottanasana is considered to be one of the important things which will be resting more pressure on the pelvic region and also the buttocks. As a result, this Padottanasana will be playing a vital role in compressing the area of the functioning region related with the Apana Vayu. And also, one more generally practiced asana in the lower level is called as Pavana Muktasana. This Pavana Muktasana will be throwing out the bad air within the body, and as a result, its name itself is called as Pavana Muktasana, release of the Pavana. And there is one more asana which is called as Sharabhasana. And Sharabhasana will be pressing the navel region and subnaval region. And the posture of the Sharabhasana will be creating more stress on the uterus region, and also it will be making the kidneys more effective and powerful. Dhanurasana is another asana which is generally practiced in order to strengthen the spine, and at the same time Dhanurasana will be helping in order to create a compression around the navel and below the navel. And there are some methods of pranayama which can be adopted for the strengthening of the apana vayu, and of that Nadi Shodhana pranayama is considered to be the best method. This Nadi Shodhana pranayama is considered to be best method because it will be creating an equal pressure on the right dimension and the left dimension of the body. That means when we take the medial line anatomically, the left portion of the body and the right portion of the body will be properly pressurized through the movement of the air in the Nadi Shodhana Pranayama. And there is one more method which is physically handling the body, that is related with the massage. Massaging the forehead, massaging the temples, massaging the nipples, massaging the occipital ridge, massaging the navel and coccyx region will be giving good effects. When we massage the forehead, temples and occipital, the total central nervous system will be properly functioning, and the pressure created around the pituitary gland will be giving a direct result for the functional and efficient operation of the apana vayu. And there are three more methods which can be adopted in the method of what is called as meditation. And concentration on Mooladhara and Manipuraka and Ajna are three centers of meditation. When we concentrate on Mooladhara, the entire anus region and subnaval region will be totally pressed. As a result, the tissues in that particular region will be totally purified. The function of the tissues and the function of the cells will be properly controlled. And when we control to the Manipuraka, which is the navel region, the three basic nadis which are moving downwards and which will be controlling the apana system will be totally and functionally powerful. And Ajna is another point which is considered to be very much important in terms of yoga. And that is why meditation on Mooladhara, meditation on Manipuraka and meditation on Ajna can be considered very, very significant. And here Recently, Vedadri Maharshi had identified a method what is called as Kaya Kalpa, wherein it starts with Ashwani Mudra and then Moolabandha, and then it will be taking an Ojas Air, and it will be ending with